the concentration of carbon dioxide, or CO2, in our atmosphere sets new records each year. Today, it's the highest it's ever been since there were people on the planet. LSU researchers in several colleges are working on solutions, bridging science, engineering, environmental and coastal sciences, as well as law and policy. Our climate crisis is an energy crisis. Fossil fuels sparked the Industrial Revolution and enabled fantastic, incredible, astounding progress over the last 250 years in everything from manufacturing to medicine. For the first time in history, power didn't have to come from human and animal muscle, but could be sourced from the stored energy of ancient sunlight. Fossil fuels, such as coal, oil, and natural gas, still provide 80% of the energy we consume in the U.S. today. When burned, they release CO2. So what can we do about it? LSU researchers are working with industry and government on developing new technologies, alternatives to fossil fuels, solar and wind power, fuel cells and hydrogen, batteries and biofuels, and energy efficiency to lessen the impact of burning fossil fuels and help lower energy bills. LSU scientists are also working on technologies to physically remove CO2 from our atmosphere. Wait, what was that again? Yes, physically remove CO2 from our atmosphere, using chemical, biological, and natural systems to trap and store CO2 safely and long-term, and make it possible to use fossil fuels in safer ways by preventing CO2 from going into the atmosphere in the first place. We can also use CO2 as a valuable source of carbon for Louisiana's growing chemical manufacturing industry, a building block for many important chemicals we need to make products we rely on every day, such as soap and shampoo, and shoes, and PPE, and PVC pipes, and foams, and fabric, and medical devices. Or, as David Dismukes in the LSU Center for Energy Studies says, products you can't make with a windmill. Louisiana leads the nation in natural gas production and has lots of fossil fuels, a strong chemical manufacturing industry, and productive wetlands that can help store a lot of carbon. LSU is now helping to leverage these resources, infrastructure, and expertise to help solve what Brian Snyder in the LSU College of the Coast and Environment calls the defining problem of the 21st century. How to lower the CO2 concentration in the atmosphere while creating new jobs and being efficient in how we use and produce energy on our planet. Louisiana has the resources, and LSU is helping to develop the necessary tools and technologies because Louisiana is the perfect place.